That's the thing about driving a distance, especially if you're alone. Driving alone is mainly just sitting and moving with the road. Stationary kind of act, but the car keeps moving while you sit still and your feet fall asleep. Your mind races like the engine, camera gone wild, but your body stays put. That's the thing about driving. Smell from the floorboard sneak up on me like burning rubber and then changes to sweet maple syrup smelling. It's funny because when it smells like burning rubber, I get worried and tense and I wonder if we'll make it. When it changes to maple sugar, I relax and feel real good about being back on the road. On the road, on the road, on the road. Visions of wrecks. Visions of wrecked stars. Jay Mansfield's severed head. Jackson Pollock.
No.
Jimmy Dean.
No.
Visions of wrecked cars. Headlight. Searchlight. Spotlight. Flashing light. Nightlight. The little glowing blue ember in the kids' room to keep away the boogeyman. Thank you. standing alone outside in the California night, standing in his python boots, staring at a kidney-shaped pool. The kind Brian died in, staring at the water, the air blowing his crow feather hair. I drive and think of a movie called The Raven, where everybody in the movie keeps saying the raven is a symbol of death. I wonder about that. I begin to wonder. Am I gonna die? Is everything a sign? Is it bad luck to take a dead raven's feather? Is it diseased? Could I die from the touch? Could I crash? I watch the curse wash away. I'm clean again. I get back in, but the feather's still there. I can't touch it again, nor the curse will never leave. I drive and drive like being chased, running away. The feather speaks. I'm sure of it, it has a voice. Its own peculiar voice. More like a minor bird than a raven. No, more like a Nevermore Edgar Poe raven voice. It doesn't matter. The character is too distinct to describe. It has a voice. It definitely speaks to me. It speaks low and soft like a feather should. It mumbles with the pistons, then stands out clear. And then shouts, and then lies quiet. I wait. Thinking maybe I should rest. Maybe it'll go away when the sun comes. Maybe. But no. The voice says this. Notice the way the sunbeam shining on the water chases you. Chases you. As though you were the only one. No escape. I'm taking you to a special place.
Me? Look, I'm sorry I took your feather and everything, but I thought you wouldn't mind. I mean, you were dead.
My body on the asphalt. My claws. My feathers speak. My bones. My feathers speak.
I know. Why is that? I can't figure that one out.
It's not for you to figure. Just follow. I'll show you the way.
But I have a date in Canada. I'm late already.
I'll take you there, then let you go.
Where? Take me where?
South.
But I'm going north.
Not anymore. And sure enough, the signs were reading South 201 and South 306 and South and South and South. How was I to know what to believe? So I went along with it. I couldn't fight it anyway. I tried turning around and going the opposite direction, but the signs still read South and South and South. So I was going south. Against my will. All on the account of a feather. Not having a radio was probably causing me to hear things in the air that weren't even there. If only I had me a radio. You'll take me south towards the ocean. You'll drive straight through until you find a car alongside a cliff. You'll park and get out of your car and walk to the blue roofless car. You'll get in on the driver's side and open the glove compartment. Inside, you'll find 6 black feathers just like mine. You'll put my feather in the glove compartment with the others and close it. Then get back in your car and you're on your way.
That's all. That's all you want me to do?
That's all. Keith and Mick, like brothers, like evil sisters in disguise, the left and right hand, the two-headed beast, the music and the words, the background and the foreground, the opposite of Paul and John, the dark and the light. I've always been pulled towards darkness, towards black, towards death, toward the south. Good. Now I'm heading in the right direction. Straight north. I've been driving for years like that. Just north. Always going north and getting nowhere. Never stopping for gas or food or sleep or friendship. Just driving. North. North.